Imagine standing under the night sky, looking up at countless stars, each one a distant sun. Now imagine being able to watch that sky, not just as a still photograph, but as a living, breathing movie. Galaxies colliding, stars being born, asteroids rushing across the void. This is the extraordinary promise of the Vera C. Rubin Observatory. High in the Chilean Andes, on a mountain peak called Cerro Pachón, an engineering marvel has been built. It is equipped with the largest digital camera ever constructed, designed not only to take single snapshots, but to film the universe in slow motion over an entire decade. In this documentary, we will explore how the Rubin Observatory works, what its first breathtaking images reveal, and how it could transform our understanding of the cosmos for generations to come. The observatory is named after Dr. Vera Rubin, a pioneering astronomer whose discoveries changed science forever. In the 1960s, when few women were seen in astronomy, Rubin studied the rotation of galaxies. She found that the stars at the edges of galaxies moved far faster than expected. The only explanation was that galaxies were filled with invisible mass, what we now call dark matter. Vera Rubin's courage and brilliance opened the door to one of the greatest mysteries in physics. And so, it is fitting that this new facility designed to confront the unknown carries her name. It is both a tribute to her legacy and a symbol of what lies ahead. The telescope itself is remarkable. Known as the Simony Survey Telescope, it uses not two mirrors like most instruments, but three. This three-mirror design allows it to capture an extraordinarily sharp and wide view of the sky. The primary mirror measures 8.4 meters across, among the largest in the world. Mounted together with a massive secondary and tertiary mirror, they work in harmony to focus starlight with exquisite precision. And at the end of this system sits the LSST camera. This camera is enormous, about the size of a small car, weighing nearly 2,800 kilograms. It produces images with an astonishing 3.2 billion pixels. To put that in perspective, you would need nearly 400 ultra-high-definition 4K televisions to display just a single image in full resolution. The Rubin Observatory's central project is called the Legacy Survey of Space and Time, or LSST. Its goal is breathtakingly ambitious: to scan the entire southern sky every 3 to 4 nights for 10 years straight. Each patch of sky will be revisited hundreds of times, building not just a map of the cosmos, but a time-lapse film of how it evolves. Imagine watching a star gradually brighten until it explodes in a brilliant supernova, or a faint asteroid slowly drifting across the field of view. Imagine seeing galaxies change, nebulae expand, and cosmic events unfold in real time. This is what Rubin will capture, a living record of the night sky. Over the decade, scientists expect the survey to generate around 500 petabytes of data. That's 500,000 terabytes. It will be one of the richest datasets in the history of astronomy, accessible not just to professional researchers, but to citizen scientists and the public worldwide. In June 2025, Rubin released its very first images. These were only test observations, lasting about 10 hours. Yet even in that short time, the telescope produced results that left astronomers astonished. One of the first mosaics, nicknamed the Cosmic Treasure Chest, combined over 1,000 exposures. It revealed the Virgo cluster 55 million light years away, in exquisite detail. Across the frame, millions of galaxies sparkle, each containing billions of stars. Some appear as graceful spirals, others as faint smudges in the background. Together, they paint a portrait of the vast architecture of the universe. Another striking image captured the Lagoon and Trifid Nebulae, vast clouds of gas and dust where stars are being born. Seen through Rubin's wide-angle lens, the nebulae appear not as isolated objects, but as part of a larger cosmic landscape. Surrounding them are star clusters, glowing clouds, and distant galaxies, all woven into a breathtaking tapestry. And in that same brief period, Rubin discovered more than 2,000 new asteroids. Among them were several near-Earth objects, thankfully none on a collision course. But the fact that so many were detected so quickly shows just how powerful this observatory truly is. The Rubin Observatory has four primary science goals. The first is to investigate dark matter and dark energy. By mapping billions of galaxies, Rubin will allow scientists to measure how the universe is expanding and why that expansion is accelerating. This could bring us closer to solving one of the greatest puzzles in cosmology. The second goal is to inventory the solar system. Rubin is expected to discover millions of asteroids and comets, including objects in the distant Kuiper Belt, and perhaps even rogue interstellar visitors like Oumuamua. By cataloging these bodies, we can better understand the origins of our solar system and assess potential threats to Earth. Thank you. The third goal is to monitor the transient sky. Supernova, gamma ray bursts, variable stars. These events flare and fade in days or even hours. Rubin's rapid survey cadence means it can catch them in the act, issuing alerts within 60 seconds of a detection. This will allow astronomers around the world to follow up with other instruments in real time. The fourth goal is to map the Milky Way. By tracking stars across vast distances, Rubin will reveal the structure and history of our galaxy. It will trace streams of stars left behind by ancient collisions, identify pulsating RR Lyrae stars at the farthest reaches, and help create the most complete 3D atlas of the Milky Way ever assembled. But building such an observatory comes with immense technical challenges. The three mirrors must stay perfectly aligned, despite temperature changes and the stresses of motion. The massive camera must remain precisely cooled and calibrated, its 189 sensors working together seamlessly. To switch between wavelengths of light, a robotic arm places giant filters in front of the detectors. Each filter allows different parts of the spectrum to be studied: ultraviolet, visible, and near-infrared, revealing details invisible to the human eye. Every night, Rubin collects around 20 terabytes of data, the equivalent of the entire Library of Congress digitized every single day. This torrent of information is sent via a dedicated 100 gigabit fiber connection to data centers in the United States, where it is processed by some of the most advanced algorithms ever developed in astronomy. These systems must automatically clean images, remove artifacts like satellite trails, and generate real-time alerts whenever something in the sky changes. It is one of the most ambitious data pipelines ever attempted in science. The broader impact of Rubin is enormous. By 2035, its data archive will be one of the largest scientific resources ever created. It will be open to the world, allowing not just astronomers, but also students, educators, and the public to explore the universe. citizen science projects will flourish, giving ordinary people the chance to contribute to real discoveries. You may not be a professional astronomer, but with access to Rubin's data, you could still be the first to notice a new supernova, a comet, or even an asteroid passing close to Earth. And because Rubin is continuously scanning the sky, it will act as a planetary defense system, spotting hazardous asteroids before they can surprise us. It may even discover rare visitors from beyond our solar system, interstellar travelers crossing our neighborhood of the galaxy. The Vera C. Rubin Observatory is more than a telescope. It is a time machine, a cosmic movie camera, and a monument to human curiosity. Already, its first images have revealed galaxies, nebulae, and asteroids in breathtaking detail. But this is only the beginning. Over the next decade, Rubin will capture the greatest film ever made, the evolving story of our universe. And all of us are invited to watch.